This video we are going to talk about the top 10 fastest cars in the world. As each passing year, the 200mph club gets less exclusive. Even the Dodge Challenger Hellcat Redeye has the ability to break the 200mph barrier. It's not only that such cars have grown more inexpensive, SUVs are beginning to push past this limit, with the Bentley Bentayga Speed claiming a top speed of 190 miles per hour, and Lister claiming a top speed of 200 miles per hour for its Jaguar F-Pace SVR-based stealth SUV. However, we've come to focus on the cream of the crop, which includes just the world's fastest production automobiles. A car must be road legal and at least 25 units must be constructed or planned in order to qualify. If you think you've found an error, keep an eye out for our honorable mentions at the end of the list. Number 10, 2020 McLaren Senna, 208 miles per hour. While all examples of the awe-inspiring McLaren Senna have been spoken for, the British manufacturer has yet to complete the intended production of 500 units. It scores lower on the list than the normal 720S on which it is based due to huge aero effects. The 789 horsepower, 4.0-litre twin-turbo V8 engine, and its 7-speed dual-clutch transmission enable the Senna to accelerate from a standstill to 60 miles per hour in only 2.7 seconds and reach a top speed of 208 miles per hour. Check out our first drive of the Senna, which convinced our writer Arthur Saint Antoine that it's one of the best supercars ever built. For the privilege of ownership, McLaren charges just under $1 million, starting price, which is much more than the 720S, which also made this list. Number 9, 2020 Ferrari F8 Tributo, 211 miles per hour. We're big admirers of the F8 Tributo, and we named it an all-star during our annual awards show. We weren't quite off our rockers enough to get it up to its max speed of 211 miles per hour during our evaluation, and we didn't need to go quite that fast to fall in love. Its 710 horsepower and 590 pound-feet of torque twin-turbo V8 engine is thrilling. Despite being one of the top 10 quickest vehicles on the road, the F8 Tributo impresses with its versatility. It's as at ease in the city and on the highway as it is exhilarating in the canyons and on track. To cut a long story short, the Ferrari F8 Tributo transforms a schlub into a monarch. The base price for a Ferrari is $275,580, but we've driven versions that cost as much as $365,741 and even $436,709. Number 8. 2020 Aston Martin DBS Superleggera, 211 miles per hour. Aston Martin's Mega GT is stunning, comfy, and capable of a mind-boggling 211 miles per hour, making it one of the world's fastest cars. We tested a pre-production example of the 2019 Aston Martin DBS Superleggera, and its massive torque had us wondering why an electric car's twist would ever be needed. The DBS Superleggera is driven by a 5.2-litre twin-turbo V12 engine that produces 715 horsepower and 664 pound-feet of torque. It's difficult to move this quickly in a more attractive package. The starting price of $308,081 is high, and we expect consumers to spend significantly more on options and modifications. Number 7, 2020 Ferrari 812 Superfast, 211 miles per hour. We'd be unhappy if this Ferrari didn't hit 211 miles per hour, especially with a moniker like Superfast. Our initial reaction to Ferrari's naturally aspirated V12 touring car, on the other hand, was anything but dissatisfaction. We named the 812 Superfast an all-star a little over a year ago, and properly so. It captured the hearts and minds of our employees just by being fantastic and fast. The 6.5-liter engine produces 789 horsepower and 530 pound-feet of torque. We can't think of a better option, if this is going to be the last naturally aspirated, non-electrified Ferrari. Do you want one? A starting price of $335,275 is expected, but expect to pay closer to $500,000 for a well-equipped model. Look no further if you want to possess what could be the greatest V12 Ferrari of all time. Number 6, 2020 McLaren 720S, 212 miles per hour. Another of our all-stars has made it onto the list of fastest production automobiles. What are we to say? For a reason, our slogan is no boring cars. During our 2018 all-stars examination, we awarded the McLaren 720S our highest honor. We found little to critique when we put the supercar through its paces despite spending more than a week with it. the 720S's responsiveness was never an issue. This McLaren is no slouch, capable of reaching 60 miles per hour in 2.5 seconds and accelerating to 212 miles per hour. It has less power than the Senna, producing only 710 horsepower, but its slippery, low downforce shape allows it to go 4 miles per hour faster at the top. If you want to park a 720S in your garage, expect to pay at least $301,500. Number 5, 2020 Ford GT, 216 miles per hour. In the same year that we selected the McLaren 720S an All-Star, we named the Ford GT an All-Star. It asks for more concessions than its British counterpart, but thanks to its no-nonsense approach, it achieves an even higher top speed. Ford's carbon fiber supercar is everything but a pipsqueak, despite being powered by the smallest and weakest engine on the list, a 3.5-liter V6 with 647 horsepower and 550 pound-feet of torque. The GT's steering, braking, and suspension setup are all phenomenal, noted editor-in-chief Mac Morrison, enabling you to attack apex curbs with an aggressive I will own you approach that seems rewards drivers more the harder they push. Number 4, 2020 Lamborghini Aventador SVJ, 217 miles per hour. With the 759 horsepower Aventador SVJ, Lamborghini was keen to prioritize both top speed and extreme aerodynamics. This is the ultimate version of the Italian automaker's flagship supercar, with enough power to further blur the lines between supercar and hypercar classifications. The 6.5-liter V12 engine produces 531 pound-feet of torque, and transmits power to all four wheels via a 7-speed single-clutch automatic transmission. We believe the Aventador SVJ, like its principal competition, the Ferrari 812 Superfast, will go down as one of the all-time greats. Number 3, 2021 McLaren Speedtail, 250 miles per hour. Notice how the peak speed of the Speedtail and the Aventador SVJ differs. That's because McLaren designed this long, low, and lean Super GT to propel a driver and two other passengers at incredible speeds. The 1,036 horsepower combo of McLaren's 4.0-liter twin-turbo V8 engine and an electric motor propels its 3,153-pound mass. Its max speed of 250 miles per hour beats out the iconic McLaren F1's 241 miles per hour, but it falls short of recovering McLaren's title of fastest production automobile in the world. The Speedtail was built to cover continents in a single bound, and we're inclined to believe it based on this recent review from our colleagues at Motor Trend. Number 2, 2020 Bugatti Chiron, 261 miles per hour. We dubbed the Bugatti Chiron a 16-cylinder tribute to the golden age of gasoline-powered opulence when we first drove it. That statement still holds true today. Until a super sport version of Bugatti's hypercar is released, this is the fastest production car currently in production. The Koenigsegg Agera RS's production ended in 2018. Bugatti's hypercar comes with an 8.0-liter quad-turbo W16 engine that produces 1,479 horsepower and 1,180 pound-feet of torque for around $3 million. Despite weighing 4,398 pounds, the all-wheel drive Chiron accelerates from 0 to 60 miles per hour in 2.5 seconds and tops out at 261 miles per hour. Only another big-budget exotic will be able to topple these milestones in terms of actual production cars. Number 1, 2021 Bugatti Chiron Supersport 300+, 304 miles per hour. The 2021 Bugatti Chiron Supersport 300+, is honored for exceeding the 300 mph barrier on the road, which is one of the most coveted automotive achievements. The max speed of the production Chiron Supersport will be electronically limited to 273.4 miles per hour for safety. Bugatti will only produce 30 Chiron Supersport 300+ cars, each costing about $4 million, and all of them have already been sold. During the 2019 LA Auto Show, we had the opportunity to see the 304 mph Bugatti Chiron, which was still splattered with dead bugs following its high-speed run. What do you think about this video? Do let us know down in the comment section below. If you enjoyed this video and want to hear from us again, be sure to hit that subscribe button before you go.